Hello everybody, welcome to our third session on teacher interaction program of computer programming. So myself Nagesh Karmali and Firuza Aibara. So we have seen that almost 5,000 and above students have are participating in this program, but we don't see we are not sure whether all the students from these respective colleges are have been enrolled for this program, and there are over 112 teachers that I see on the dashboard. So we'll quickly go through each of the remote centers. Let us go to Raisoni College of Engineering. Raisoni College of Engineering, that is 1012. Oh, nobody is there. Oh, no, there is somebody. There is somebody. Hello.
No audio.
Mic is your mic is not. There is no audio.
No audio. Please check your mic. There is no audio from your side.
Please check your mic. Okay, we'll come back to your center later. Meanwhile, you can correct your technical problem. Next is Samrat Ashok Technological Institute.
Hello.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, sir.
Hello.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah, you can turn around 90 degrees towards the left.
Hello.
Yeah, I can hear you.
Hello.
You.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, hello.
How about you, ask. Please speak. We can hear you.
Voice is audible or not?
Yes,
it is audible. Yes, please speak.
Yes, sir. Actually, in the Moodle server, I have mentioned about the syllabus. The syllabus of our institute and that IIT Bombay, and both are different. In our syllabus, we have E, but in your syllabus, you are having C++. So how students will get, will study that course? So yes, sir.
Yes,
getting
so
my point.
So the question is, the syllabus that we cover is C++, and your college syllabus is C. Is that correct? And how do you tackle the situation?
It is totally different. We are in first year. We have only C.
Okay.
But according to your course content, we have C++.
Okay. So let me answer this. We don't have C++ at all in our first course. So it is only C, and the only constructs that we use are C in and C out. Rest everything is C. It's only purely procedural. So the second part of the course, which are not offered, it is an object oriented programming course where you start with structures and objects, and then go on with standard template library. So this is purely a C course. Only the construct, the input output construct for this course, we are using C in and C out, defined in the IO stream library. That's it. Rest everything is same.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. So, how many students how many of your students are participating?
Actually, sir, in first year admission is going on.
Oh, okay.
And after 15th of August, I will be enrolling those students in that course.
13th
right
of
now,
August.
I am studying those flights.
Okay.
So after 15th of August.
Oh, so here.
So I have
here,
seen those lectures.
Here we have the information that your course starts from 1st of August or 1st of July, which is not correct, is it? So 13th of August.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Actually, sir, there is a slight change in our counseling status.
Okay.
So,
okay.
There is some college level counseling, which is up to 15th of August. And after 15th of August, we will be enrolling those students.
And your course ends on 15th of November?
15th. This time we are slightly late because of that counseling schedule.
Okay. And what is your end date? The end date is also shifted?
Sir, actually our end date is 10th of August, but the students will schedule their classes from 16th of August.
No.
As per the instructions.
I am saying end of the semester.
End of semester is November.
Oh.
20th of.
Okay. So you have any other questions?
Sir. From the next year, you have the syllabus according to your course conduction. We are planning in that way only. Because we have some basic information about computer network, operating system, DBMS and all in that part. And now we are planning to change your syllabus according to your syllabus and matching with it. Have some comfortable in that.
Yeah.
And
you can go through the syllabus. We have put it up on BMW, that is Blended MOOCs workshop program which we are running it through the IIT Bombay X. So that course has got full information on what are the topics which are covered for this course. Subsequently, we'll also put up the next course over a period of time, wherein you would be able to see the C++ the syllabus for the C++ course.
One more point, sir.
Yes.
Actually, here we are doing the programming on that normal OS, that is Windows 7 and all. And I think that first year students will find
it. Can you hold the mic a bit closer?
Work on that Ubuntu.
Sorry.
Hold the mic a bit closer.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes.
The question is that our first students are uncomfortable with that Ubuntu that I found. Other year students. So I found that the first year students may have some problem with Ubuntu and all.
Okay,
we have Windows 7 and all, we can work on order at all.
Yes, I understood your question. So you are saying that some students have problem with Windows and wherein we are running using Ubuntu as an environment and students have some problem. So I don't think there is any problem because if you are using Windows, you can do the programming, the same set of programs that have been written on Ubuntu, they will work on Windows without any modification. Okay, that is defined by the ANSI standards. It is not defined by any operating system. So it is defined by some standard body which says that this particular construct will run. And if that compiler is put in place, it will give you the same results. Okay, so you have GCC compilers under Windows, you have even Turbo C++ if you want to use, you can use it. Now why we are using Ubuntu? The reason is that it's open source and there are lots and lots of additional utilities which you can directly use, wherein Windows When you want to use something, you have to buy and install it. All the time you have to pay money. So for a student, you know, the best operating system is Ubuntu, wherein he need not even pay for the Word that is available, the Office, you know, LibreOffice which comes with it, and many other utilities. You can, you know, the whole lot of command system which a student can learn additional to the course material which is being taught. You know, the students can get their own, you know, they can start on their own rather than you teaching them or we teaching them how to use Ubuntu. In fact, I mean, people generally learn that way much faster. Like if you see the kids of today, they have mobiles. Nobody teach them how to use mobiles, right? So they just fiddle with the mobile and they come to know what happens with the mobile. They know how to send SMSs. Nobody teaches them how to send SMSs. So, I mean, you should leave it to the students, because the students are much smarter today. They can do wonders.
Yes, sir, you are right. You are right, sir. But if we are comparing with IIT Mumbai,
no.
It will be quite difficult.
All students have got, I mean, they want to learn, right? If you give them in the environment, they will learn. But if you do not give them the environment, if you restrict yourself to saying that I will use only Windows, then students also will use only Windows, no? Now, if you yourself start using Ubuntu or some other operating system, so they also may start using it.
Yes, sir, you are right. But in the earlier classes, in the earlier years,
yeah,
I have found that many of the students doesn't know how to open a computer or to start a computer or to turn off a computer.
Right. So in the beginning, so you can do some hand holding. Of course, I agree that there are some students, not all 100% population will know how to use it. I agree with you. But there are some students wherein you can actually give a special class only using how to use a computer. I mean, that is possible, and we have put up some videos also wherein they can learn how to use a basic system.
I have seen that.
Yes.
I have seen that from starting point, that they are opening a switch and how the system works on.
Right.
Well, we will work on Ubuntu.
But there is,
and we will see that.
As I said, there is no problem in using Windows. You can use Windows. There is no problem. I mean, you can use Windows, you can run all of your programs on Windows.
Okay. No problem. But I am asking about the student's perspective. But we will work on Ubuntu, no problem at all.
Okay, so there is Professor Fatak here. We'll ask him to join. Can we go to center?
Good afternoon, everybody. Sorry for joining a bit late. There is a workshop here in NIT Rourkela which I was attending. I am happy to contribute to any discussion. I thought the discussion was going on well, but if there are any questions that people need to ask, since I do not know, we can control the interaction from here, or they will have to do it. We can do that.
You can.
Okay, so there are a number of institutions which have logged in. Let me go to a college which was earlier, has not interacted, perhaps. Adi Shankara College, did we interact with them? This is in Nellore. I'm going over to Adi Shankara College.
Adi Shankara College.
Oh, they're not publishing their video. All right. So let me go to some other college. G.H. Raiswani College. I have already interacted once, I think. Let me start that. NMIMS has a query. I am seeing G.H. Raiswani College. Over to you.
Hello. Good afternoon,
yeah,
sir.
Please go ahead. Good afternoon.
Sir, actually we have started the college around 8th of July, sir. First year classes I am asking. Sir, now it's time to give some assignments. So I want to ask whether this video lecture, I mean, there would be assignments given by this video lecture?
Yes, there are. If you see the first week portion, which is there in the BMW course also, you will see that there are some practice assignments. The first graded quiz is supposed to happen only around 14th August, I think, and that is to accommodate all the other colleges which started late. However, if you wish, what we will do is, we will email you a set of additional quizzes which you can conduct with your students independently. If Nagesh is listening, I would request Nagesh to note down that some additional quizzes from some of our earlier conducted quizzes could be taken in the text format and could be emailed to all instructors, in fact, across the country, all the participating institutions. And if they wish, they can conduct that assignment whenever it is relevant locally and assign marks locally also. We'll send you that. That's
sir,
a good
thing. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you. NMIMS has a query here. So,
good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, I have a question that in this current semester we have C as a programming language that we are teaching to our first year student, and the course material is of C++. So, it's a bit problematic.
No, I think your colleagues have not seen the course material. There is hardly any C++ concept involved, meaning there is absolutely no object-oriented material that is being discussed in the 101.1. All that is discussed is actually procedural programming. It is called C++ only because we use C++ compiler. The only features of C++ which we are using are C in and C out. Although we will introduce printf and scanf later, you can tell your student that what they are doing is they are writing C programs only, but instead of using scanf and printf, we are using C in and C out, and we have to compile the programs using C++ compiler. But otherwise, there is absolutely no difference between the programs that we write here and the programs that are written in a C programming class.
Right, sir.
I will probably over this weekend, I will prepare an additional small video clarifying this C and C++ thing. As a matter of fact, and this is one assignment I would like to give to all our teacher participants of this course, they should rewrite all sample programs that have been given in plain C, meaning without changing the rest of the program. They should replace C in and C out by the appropriate scanf and printf statement so that they can be compiled using C program, a C compiler.
Right, sir. So we are trying to upload the student list on BMW platform, and we are facing some problem uploading it.
Can you mention the problem faced? We will try to resolve them.
Sir, it's not actually getting uploaded. We 3 to 4 teachers are trying to do that for our respective classes. So it's not getting that thing is not getting uploaded over there.
I am in Rourkela and I'll be reaching back only 2 days later. But I will cross-check this. Meanwhile, I'll request Nagesh to talk to our programmer Shweta, and she should clarify.
Sure,
but there is maybe some problem in the exact formatting that you have used. Incidentally, this is not only for you, but for the benefit of all others as well. Please remember that the list that you upload should be created after collecting data from students. And students are required to give exactly the same email ID that they have used for registering on IIT Bombay. Otherwise, there will be confusion.
Okay, sir.
Can you tell us what error message are you getting?
Sir, student is not registered kind of errors we are getting. Actually,
no,
we did registration on...
student is not...
We did registration on Moodle.
Okay.
And thereafter we are uploading it.
No. You don't understand. Students don't register on Moodle. Students have to register on IIT Bombay X on the CS101.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. On that IIT Bombay X dot in,
right.
They registered over there. They have created their account, and we are trying to upload a list of their email IDs and usernames.
But they should enroll on CS101 also, no? On IIT Bombay X.
Right, sir.
See,
that
what
we did.
Yeah. So what we do is ask the students, by the way, to demonstrate in front of you that they should log in onto IIT Bombay X using the same email ID, and that they should be able to see their code. So that way you will be sure that they have registered. Because All that our software does is, whatever list you give, for every entry, that software simply goes back and cross-checks with IIT Bombay X registration information. And if it is there, it will report that the student is registered and enrolled. If it is not there, it will report an error message. So consequently, there is absolutely no scope for any error. If the student has registered, just check whether there is a small spelling mistake in his email ID or some such thing. That's the only possibility.
Okay.
I will anyway get it cross-checked with my staff.
Sure, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you. There are some questions raised here. So let me go to... is NIT Manipur.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir. Sir, I have some doubt regarding this program.
Yes, please go ahead.
Please, sir, is there any specific compiler preferred by the IIT Bombay for using C programming?
We use GCC. The GCC compiler is what is used always by us, and that is what we recommend in the code blocks also. When you install code block, you will automatically install it with GCC compiler. That is what we suggest as a preferred compiler.
Sir, in our previous semesters, we use Turbo C. Turbo C and the DFC++ like that. Is it possible to work in depth only, means Turbo C and DFC++?
It is not possible for two reasons. First of all, Turbo C is not an open source product. Further, the Turbo C is duplicate. When earlier Turbo C had released it for open free usage, but now it has been acquired by a company. So it is illegal to use Turbo C by any student or any one of us. And we would not like to promote use of non-legal software. That is one of the main reasons. Secondly, Turbo C is good for compiling short programs on a PC kind of environment. But we are trying to train our students such that they will compile very large systems eventually using C++, for which they will have to use the GCC or an industry-grade compiler. So it is better to start off. I understand that initially they may have some problems because the interface is not easy as Turbo C is. But if they use code block, so then they will find it quite easy to write programs, compile them, debug them, etc. My suggestion is to please tell them that while initially there are some problems and hesitation to use code blocks and GCC, but in a very short while, within a week, if they practice sufficiently, they will be able to sort out these problems.
Sir, I have 10 doubts about starting this online class. Hello, sir. Hello.
Yes.
Sir, will IIT Bombay be conducting any online class for the students?
Yes, what we had agreed is that when all the admissions to all colleges are over, then whenever we make our discussions, we can have an extended period where every college can arrange for their students to be in a classroom, and all of us will be very glad to interact with the students also. All that we want is, we want to keep the interaction with teachers separate and interaction with students separate. Of course, all local teachers should be present when we interact with students. So one suggestion was that on Tuesday itself, when we have alternate Tuesday our discussion, then we can have 2:30 to 3:30 or 2 to 3:30 our discussion with teachers, and from 3:30 to 5 o'clock or so, we can have discussion with students. That is one possibility. Another possibility is, if you prefer any other time which is more convenient to students across all institutions, we do not mind arranging an interaction with students on such day also. Maybe what I will do is, on 7th, I will put up a survey on the Moodle asking for preferred date and time, giving some options, and you can fill them up, and we can start this interaction from next week itself with your students, who can directly ask us questions and doubts and so on.
I think that if there is any online class for the students selected by the IIT Bombay, it will be very beneficial for the students also.
Yes, we'll do that definitely.
And sir, for the students, for a student's sake, is there any material provided by the IIT Bombay that they can use during this program?
During this program, the only thing that we have is the planned interaction with students. We have nothing else to offer, really.
Right.
So that's all we will be arranging. I will be conducting a Moodle quiz on 7th or something, where you can respond with the suggested dates and timings. We'll suggest some dates, you can choose which one is preferable. I don't mind and doing two sessions also if it is required. All right. Thank you. There is a question from Kukatpalli. This is Great Kukatpalli, Hyderabad.
Hello?
Hello, good afternoon.
Very good afternoon, sir. We are calling from Gokaraja Rangaraj Institute of Technology from Hyderabad. It's really a pleasure to be at the part of the IIT MOOCs. So we are having a question like, will this AVU class will be on every Tuesday afternoon? What is the timetable of this one so that we can fix our timetables?
We had decided to have on alternate week. That is what was decided, that we will have on alternate week. You see, this is part of the teacher training workshop, and as per our understanding with IST, we have to have so many face-to-face sessions with the teacher. Now, since this workshop is elongated for the full semester, we have that in 14 weeks, if we have 6 or 7 interactions, that will be good enough. That is why we had planned it every 2 weeks. If you want any change in the timetable or if you have any suggestions, then we do not mind doing it every week. Although I will have to check my own timetable when I am available, and it may not be on then every Tuesday. Every alternate Tuesday I have chosen. But one possibility is, for example, most of the institutions first year students would have joined. Have first year students joined in your college?
Actually, these admissions are going, sir, by the next Thursday, that is the coming Thursday, the students will be attending the class.
Right. So this is one of the issues that we have across the country. Some colleges start early, some colleges start a bit late, but that is okay. So to answer your question again, for the time being, we have decided to meet every alternate Tuesday to resolve any issues that teachers have. However, if you want it more frequently, during, let us say, month of September or later part of August, you can make such suggestion. Start a discussion thread on Moodle suggesting that there could be more frequent interaction, say every week or so, and suggest some alternate time. And let us see how our colleagues from other institutions react. If there is a common time that is found to be suitable, I do not mind, for example, having a discussion session with students on a Saturday also, if that is more convenient to them. So you will have to find a common time which is suitable to all. I am open to suggestions, and we can increase the frequency. As of now, we have decided to meet on alternate Tuesdays. All right? I'm going over to BMS College of Engineering.
Good afternoon, Professor.
Good afternoon.
Professor, I have a question or two. The first question is, who will be grading programming assignments? Will it be online or can we make it manual?
All programming assignments are graded automatically. You see, the MOOC philosophy itself, because of the term massive. Massive means human grading is either not possible or is possible through two specific mechanisms, such as either peer grading or an autograder. The autograder itself could be of two types. One is a machine learning type algorithm, which can be used for text type answers. But for computer programming courses, we have created an autograder which can evaluate every submission. And it is not a 0-1 kind of autograder. As you will find, if you go through the sample programs of the last year, which are located on the BMW workshop course for teachers, you will find that programming assignments have 3 or 4 divisions. And each division, people have to score separately. So it is possible for students to score partial marks. But they are essentially auto-graded assignments or programming.
Yeah. The other thing is, Professor, the last time in the last meeting, you told that you are uploading some sample lab programs, which you haven't.
I hope Nagesh and Firuz are listening. Nagesh, can you do me a favor? I will be coming back on 6th night from Delhi. So on 7th, if you could briefly meet, I want you to collect all the old sample lab assignments. Okay. So Nagesh has just said that we will do that. It means that much before 7th itself, my colleague, Mr. Nagesh Karmali, my research associate and senior research manager, he agrees that he will collect all the previous lab assignments that we had used in our CS101 course, and we'll upload them on the Moodle, so that in the workshop course, you can look at those Moodle assignments. I'll also ask him to upload them on the BMW, so that either of them, you will be able to access that. Thank you for reminding us, and sorry that we forgot to do that. We had promised that.
Not at all. One more thing is, could we get the consolidated report of quiz marks of students?
Yes. It is good that you asked this question. So my answer is meant for all the colleague teachers who are participating. You will actually get, once the students are uploaded and once the quizzes and online assessment start, then anytime you click, typically after any quiz is conducted and the submission time is over, you will get marks of all the students who have given all the online assignments so far. So suppose you click after the 4th quiz is given, then at that time you will be able to download a CSV file which will have marks for quiz 1, quiz 2, quiz 3, quiz 4. And progressively you will keep getting it. In the end, when you click, you will get marks of all quizzes, all programming assignments, final marks, etc., etc. Once you get these marks, and this is important, because there was a question asked by many people even earlier, do you blindly take a certain percentage of total score and add it to your score to decide the final grade? My answer to this question was no, it is not necessary, although you can do that. But suppose you find that there are certain topics okay, which are closer in overlap with the topic that you cover in your college, and you may decide that you will consider marks only for, say, quiz 3, quiz 5, quiz 7, quiz 8 and quiz 9. Or you will take two best quizzes out of four and the final exam. Now, these choices are entirely yours because you are an autonomous institution. All that we desire is that the minimum weightage given to the MOOC score should not fall below 20% and should not exceed 80%. In what manner do you get the MOOC score established is entirely your choice. However, I would suggest for fairness and transparency that this decision be made upfront and announced to the students. After they complete their quizzes, you cannot say that I will be considering marks of quiz 3, quiz 4, quiz 5.
For that last purpose, question,
I would suggest that you go through the quizzes that were conducted last time, which are there in that workshop course. They are now old-time quizzes. They will not be repeated, of course. But the nature of the quizzes you will be able to understand and the topic. This time we are combining certain topics, okay, for the conduct of quizzes because quizzes are getting compressed. But essentially, you should be able to make a decision. My suggestion will be, do not announce an absolute pickup of certain quizzes already. That is, don't say that your marks will be as obtained in quiz 5, quiz 6, quiz 8. And that's it. Because if somebody does badly in a quiz, that student will feel bad. In general, in IIT system, we always say, best so many marks out of so many quizzes. So even in our course, regular course, IIT Bombay XCS101X, I think we have said best 4 out of 6 or some such number. You can enhance it or you can choose any one of it. So for example, if you decide to use quiz 1, 2, 4, 5 and 6, then you say these are the 5 quizzes. Out of these 5 quizzes, your best score in 3 quizzes will be considered. Some such statement you can make. But that is your decision entirely.
Yeah, the last question.
Yes.
See, the one thing is, can we lock the quiz timings or help from IIT Bombay to lock the quiz timings for supervision and other things? And we have a major share of strength here with respect to students. So can we expect 3 to 4 different set of quiz set because we are conducting it in batches?
You can, you are conducting them in batches? No, that is not possible. What we are proposing to do is that we will give only one set of quizzes. What you can do is probably you can conduct 2 batches one after another. The way we handled it in IIT Bombay also last year was like this, that while one batch is giving the quiz, online quiz, the other batch is made to sit in a classroom under the supervision of some staff. That means they are not able to see the quiz. When one batch finishes and leaves the lab, the other batch goes in. And the quiz is already open. So whenever they log in, they will get the same quiz, but we are introducing randomness in the variables and other things. So that, for example, if you get, say, question 4, the question 4 which comes to me may look different completely. It will be on the same theme. But the choice answer, suppose B was correct in your case, in my case, D may be correct. The randomization will ensure different set of questions for different quizzes anyway. So even if you have batches after batches, personally, I don't think it will make any difference. See, after all, we are willing to accept the honor code certification for their normal IIT Bombay certification. What I suggest you can do is just to make sure that there is a semblance of supervision which is visible to them. You may say that on alternate days, you will supervise alternate batches or some such thing, just for the sake of supervision.
Yeah, thank you, Professor. We are starting instructions from tomorrow, and all our team is very curious, enthusiastic about this program. Thanks a lot for introducing, giving us an opportunity.
Thank you very much. In fact, I will be looking forward to feedback from you because you are among the few people who are doing it very methodically. So I look forward to your feedback.
Thanks a lot, Professor.
Mukesh Patel, School of Engineering.
Good afternoon, sir. Can you hear us?
Yes, we can. Loud and clear.
Okay. Sir, the question is regarding one, our registrations, I mean the admissions for the first year is still going on. I mean there's some kind of shuffling which is going on. So can the date for the registration or enrollment of the students be increased?
Yes, it will be. I have already issued instructions to increase it. Just tell me approximately by what date you will complete.
Around 10th of August, sir.
So I think I will instruct them to go even beyond 15th of August. Independence Day will be a good enough criteria.
Yeah, sir. Thank you so much. So the other question which is there, you talked about the validity of a quiz last time when we interacted to you, that it could be like 2 days when a quiz opens on some evening, like let's say Tuesday, and it is only valid for 2 days. So what we were thinking, can that validity be increased to 1 week so that we can do a supervised quiz for all the students in different batches that we take for different practical labs?
No, you cannot do it because the quiz is open. The same quiz is given to everyone. So if you have given the quiz on Monday and my batch is on Tuesday, by Monday evening I will come to you and know all the quiz questions that are being asked. So when I go to appear for my quiz, I would generally know the nature. I might randomize something, but that will not change the nature of the quiz.
Okay, so we cannot increase the validity then, that is what you are saying.
The whole idea of the supervision was as follows, and this unfortunately can be executed only by those institutions which have large number of PCs available. The idea is like this: on Tuesday afternoon 4 o'clock we release the quiz. It will remain open for 2 days for general public who are doing that course. But if you want to organize supervision, you should organize from 4 to 5 on the same day for all students of your school.
Okay.
So use laboratories from mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, civil
engineering. Okay, sir. Okay.
To the lab where there is an internet connection and have supervision by teaching assistants in different batches, but they all report at 4 o'clock. And their quiz time you can decide say 1 hour quiz or half an hour quiz, and you can supervise from 4 to 5. It is exactly like a rent semester examination.
Okay.
You can conduct it in that.
Yeah. Okay, okay, sir. Okay, sir, that's it.
Okay.
Okay, thank you so much, sir, for your time.
Let me go to Adi Shankara College. Question from Adi Shankara. They are publishing their video now. Over to you.
Good afternoon, Professor.
Good afternoon,
Professor. I have one doubt. Now in our college admission process is going on. It may be completed at 10th of August. After that, can we register our students, sir?
Yes. The similar question was asked just by the teacher from the previous institution that we interacted. I told them that I'll keep it up to 15th August. I just got a confirmation that it is not up to 15th August, but it is even beyond that. Where is the chart here? Oops, sorry. There is a chart here.
Okay, okay. Thank you, sir.
I think I have another question. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes, please.
Do you have any plans for conducting classes, sir, for students?
Yeah, this question also I have answered.
Sir, do you have any plans for conduct classes for students?
Okay. Can you hear me, first of all? If you can hear me, just raise your hand, please.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So the plan is not actually to conduct classes for the students, but to have interaction session where they can ask their doubts directly and we would try to clear them. And these interaction sessions are planned. They are not compulsory or obligatory, but any institution such as yours, if you wish to arrange or facilitate this, then immediately after completion of our interaction on Tuesday, that is 2:30 to 3:30 or so, we can have a 1 hour session with the student, which could be arranged in either the same classroom or elsewhere. And what we'll do is we'll take a 5 minute break when the interaction with teachers end. Then the students can come in and I will be very glad to address them. Let us say I can give them a brief 10-minute lecture for the material that is covered in that week or in the previous week and ask them to ask questions. And just like you are interacting with us, they can also ask questions directly. I think they will like the facility, isn't it? What is your opinion?
Okay, my opinion is good programming, sir. It is very good. In our classroom, directly conducting conducting the classes, interaction with students with 5 or 10
right.
minutes.
Right, right.
Or 1 hour. 1 hour.
1 hour. It will be okay. 1 hour, but there will be students from all colleges also coming. So just like we will be using the same AVU, so if there is a hand raised from your college, some student wants to ask a doubt, we will go to that college and we'll ask that student to interact. Actually, students will like it because they will realize that they are not asking this question to me alone, but they are being seen and watched by thousands of other students in other 50 colleges also. So they will have a feeling of a participation in a much larger activity. I think that will be useful.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you for your valuable.
Thank you. Let me go over to Yashwantra Chavan College. Yes, over to you.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, the question of whatever the question that I want to ask you, that question already asked by the someone. So I got the answer of that question. So our registration processing.
I will request you to please repeat the question and answer so that I can detect the noise level in the answer.
Okay, sir. Thank you. I have seen the syllabus. I have downloaded the syllabus from the Moodle, and in that syllabus, I have seen the most of the things is related to the C++. So I have little bit confused, but my confusion is get cleared by you before some time. That you have already told that C in and C out only statement that we are going to use, and then rest of the concepts are just related to the plain C language.
That's
so right. I have already uploaded the syllabus of my institute regarding the C language, and okay. We are going to process this activity by registration of the students and all these things in a quick time.
When does the admission finish in your college, and when will classes start for first year students?
Classes is already started from 27th of July. Just now.
Very good.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much. There is student 15. I do not know what is this student. Is it our own thing or let me see what this is?
Hello.
I can't recognize you. What college is this? Over to you.
Hello, good afternoon to you, sir.
Good afternoon.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Yeah, good afternoon. Please speak.
Actually, we have registered our students and also our faculty for the course. Since the registration has closed, so students from other departments like ECE, mechanical also want to register. So can they register now?
Yes, of course. Now? The registration is open till what I said, I think about 19th July, 19th August or something. So the registration is open. As far as we are concerned, we will treat them as CS101 students from your college, which is RVR and JC. But you will have to maintain records internally to ensure that you don't confuse between your students and other departmental students. See, as far as we are concerned, anybody can register on IIT Bombay. Now, once we get a list from you, suppose we get a list of 120 students from you, we will all treat them as the 120 students from your college. Now, if 20 of them are from other departments, it is for you to separate out their marks or not consider them or whatever. We have absolutely no problem. If many more students from other departments also want to join this endeavor through you, they are most welcome. Absolutely no problem.
Thank you, sir. I have one more question. So, yes. Once the training is over, do they have to go any internal evaluation from our side so that they have completed successfully the preliminary fundamentals? Only IIT Bombay can do the final evaluation. Okay, as a evaluation process, do we need to evaluate?
There are two aspects of evaluation process. One is the evaluation that is done for IIT Bombay X for CS101.1X, for which the students are registered. Independent of whether they are studying in your college or elsewhere, they are expected to complete all the online assessment to be eligible to get the honor code certificate from IIT Bombay. Now there, the college doesn't come into picture at all. The learners are directly registering, they are completing the online activity, and based on whether they get adequate marks and scores or not, on the online score, they will get their honor code certificate. Now let us come back to the blended MOOC, where the students are being mentored by you as well as they are doing the online course. In this particular case, IIT Bombay does not give any grade at all. The grade to the students is given by your college only, just like you will give them a grade in their normal course. Now, for giving this grade, you have to choose judiciously how much percentage of weightage you want to give to online test and how much percentage of weightage you want to give to your own assessment. Please note that by participating in the blended MOOC, you should not do zero assessment at your level. You must do your own assessments, either programming submission or any other exam that you want to conduct, that is up to you as an autonomous institution. All that we are saying is that when you give us a list of these 100 students, we will keep providing you with the marks which these 100 students have scored in each of the quizzes here. Now these are, you can download. Finally, when you decide on a grade of your course for the student, you will decide it as a combination of marks that they have scored on the online portion plus the marks that they have scored in your own evaluation. All that we have stated in the blended MOOC experiment is that you should not give less than 20% weightage to the online assessment which IIT Bombay conducts and gives you the marks, and you should not give it more than 80% weightage. You can decide in between some percentage and then accordingly conduct your own assessment, whether in the form of quiz, test or exam paper or whatever. But as an autonomous institution, it is entirely your judgment.
Okay, sir. So on behalf of all our team members, we would like to thank you for accepting our confirmation as a remote center. So thank
yes,
you once again.
I think you joined at the last moment, right?
Yes, sir. Definitely.
Who is the remote center coordinator at your place?
Dr. MVP Chandrasekhar Rao, sir, professor in CSE department. So he is on a workshop in Chennai.
Okay. I would like to compliment your institution, because in spite of our saying no, 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 you always kept saying yes, 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 and pestered us till no end. I still remember the last meeting that I had late night, where my team said that, sir, there are so many persistent requests coming from them, and they had almost completed everything, so why can't we add that? Let me tell you that there are 250 other pending requests, and if they come to know that I have admitted you last moment because you have agreed to participate in the blended MOOC operation, someday they will hit me on the head. But my compliments for your persistence. And let us see whether how much our students benefit. That is the test, right? By the way, this is for all people. The last date of registration and enrollment by your students on IIT Bombay Act for 101 SES 101H has been extended up to 25th August.
Okay, thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Right. Thank you. Looks like all questions are over here. So I just wanted to let me talk to our testing teacher is Firuza and others, is it? Yeah. Okay. Hello, Firuza. So Nagesh, these questions have been answered. Hello, Nagesh, can you hear me? Can you hear me?
I can hear you, yeah. Hello, sir.
Okay. So I hope you have made notes of the questions that they have asked.
Yeah.
And we have to do two things. One is upload the lab assignments in the BMW course. And you might as well put it also on Moodle. Hmm. And find out from Shweta if there is any specific problem about uploading of that particular file, whatever it is.
Right. And in fact, I heard from the eOutreach team that they were uploading a csv.txt file, some of them. So that could also lead to a problem.
Okay. So, by the way, this is for all colleague teachers. When you upload the CSV file, please ensure that the extension is proper. It should have a proper file name extension. It should be a plain text file. So please confirm that you don't upload any executable file or you don't upload any spreadsheet file. It should be a text file, comma separated value. Maybe one suggestion is that we could take make some sample file with a file name and upload it there, so that they know exactly how it should look like.
Yeah, it has been uploaded. The sample file name is uploaded.
It has been uploaded. All right. So request to all colleague teachers is they should see the sample uploaded file, particularly look at the name of the file. The name of the file and file name extension has to clearly indicate that it is a text file of the CSV type. So use that to upload. Well, that's all. Thank you very much. Over and out.
Yes.
We'll see you.
Just a minute.
Yeah.
One possible other possible problem could be the username which they have uploaded may not be the same as the IIT Bombay X username. That could be one of the issues.
I mentioned that, so they should take care by asking the student, such student who is shown as non-registered.
Right.
They should call the student to, let's say, my office. I'll call the student and tell him, please log in onto this and show me what is your login ID and username.
Email ID.
Then I can confirm whether he has made a goof up or not.
Right.
And for the colleague teacher, this is a reminder again. Please ensure that your student not only register on IIT Bombay X and enroll for CS101.1X, but also they give you exactly the same identical email ID which they have used for registration on IIT Bombay X and the public username which they have given while registering on IIT Bombay X. The roll number, the email ID and public username has to be identical along with other information which you may give, full name, roll number, etc. etc. Our software takes your uploaded file and cross checks with whatever you have entered as email and public user ID. If they don't match, then you will get an error saying that the student is not registered. All right. With that, we come to the conclusion of this session. Thank you very much. Over and out.
Hello. If there are any more questions, then we are ready to take. You can raise your hands.
Yes, Mepko, do you have any questions? if there are any questions from other colleges, yeah. Please press the hand raise button.
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon. Hello?
Hello. I can hear
you. Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, I can hear you very well. Do you have any question?
Sir, in the IITX Bombay site, sir, there is course slides is uploaded as a like PDF file like that you have uploaded. Another one, YouTube file you have uploaded. When we go through the course file, I can't attend the quizzes. I think only through YouTube, if I attend, then only that course progress will be.
So let me understand the question. So you are saying the videos have been uploaded, which is having a YouTube link. And the slides are also uploaded, which are in PDF form. And the third thing is that the quizzes, you are not able to take any quizzes. Am I right?
Yes.
So on the platform itself, you have a video streaming that is happening from YouTube. Okay, so the video has been uploaded on YouTube, but the streaming happens on this platform. And along with the streaming, you also have a capability of subtitling and other things. You can fast forward and whatever, you know, captions are visible or subtitles, that's a part of the YouTube facility. Second thing is your slides are uploaded in PDF format. Slides are also uploaded as a course slides. There is another tab wherein you can go and check this all set of slides which have been uploaded. Oh, sorry, it is for students. For students, it has been uploaded in that fashion. And for the quizzes, you may not be able to take the quizzes. Right. So what you can do is you can actually take the quizzes on students' platform. So you can independently roll yourself on the students' platform, and you can take those quizzes because the dates are not set. So the quizzes which are shown to you are the ones which are already past due date. It's a past material. Yeah, have I cleared your doubt or? Can I know whether you are able to take the quizzes or not able to take the quizzes?
Not able to pick the quizzes in that PDF form, and in cross one graph you have given is course progress. Mm-hmm. There is one graph like structure for course progress.
Yeah, so course progress.
That is not at all moving. I have viewed all the slides.
Okay.
But it is always showing 0%.
Right. It will always show 0% because the due date is past date. But I think you should be able to see the quizzes. Quizzes, I don't think there will be a problem. So you are talking about your performance data, right? The data that, you know, it's a temporal data over a period of time that the progress gets accumulated and gets stored somewhere. So that happens only during the running of the course. So what you can do is you can actually enroll in the student's course also and see your performance. I mean there.
I would like to go over to the course link again if they are still there. Yeah, I am Patek here. I would like to further add.
Good afternoon, sir.
So let me tell you that the bar that you see, progress bar that you see, is actually not meant for teachers. It is meant for individual students.
Okay, sir.
It is meant for individual students who are doing the course in CS 101.1H. Now, we could have easily kept the similar quizzes on BMW workshop also, in which case you would have been able to see your progress. But But the idea is not to evaluate and assess teachers. That is why we did not put it there.
Okay, sir.
As Nagesh said, those of you who are curious can additionally enroll for CS101. After all, you are not working for that certificate there. But just enroll for there. In fact, it will be a lot of fun because you will then be able to see the discussion forum that is happening with the actual students, and you will see the kind of quizzes that they will see. It did not occur to me, but now that your question has prodded me to think, it seems to be an excellent idea that all my teacher colleagues should also enroll on CS101.1X so that they will see the fun that the students are going through.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
There is another old one. Or it's a new query raised by NMIMS.
Sir, we have a problem. Like yesterday, we received a mail from e-outreach which stated how to upload the list of the students who have enrolled. But as soon as we click the link, it shows page cannot be displayed. Like link is not displayed. We tried that thing several times, but that link is not opening. Every time it is showing page cannot be displayed.
Are you enrolled properly as a teacher?
Yes, sir. Sir, all of us are enrolled and every member has tried that, like clicking on that link.
How come other institutes are able to do that? Do me a favor, when you get an error message, you capture that screen. Okay, you say print screen and store that image. And send that image as an attachment to e-outreach. And they can discuss it with our programmers and find out quickly if there is a fix that is required. But along with that image, also give clear statements as to which email ID you use, when did you log in, and when did you try this link. Please do that and they should be able to correct.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Have your course started already?
No, sir. Sir, we have started the course, but we have started the enrolling the students, but because we have not able to add the students to your course.
No. I am saying whether you have started the course.
And our regular college actually. Yeah, our regular college started on 20th of July, and after that we have started the process of enrolling students.
Achha, but first year students have joined already.
Yes, sir. They have joined.
Fine. So I am handing over control to Nagesh. Nagesh and Firuza will handle if there are any more questions. I don't see any hand raised here. So thank you very much. Over and out. I'll now go for the workshop.
So if there are any other questions, please press the hand raise button, or we'll just check each college, which we'll just take random colleges. NIT Warangal.
Hello. If you do not have any other question, then you can simply say about the conduct of the course in your own institute.
Yeah. We just started the course on this Monday onwards. Okay. And it's going to finish on the 23rd. So, 23rd of November, that is. And we intend to have two internal exams for 10 marks each, and then 30 marks mid exam, so, and an end exam for 50 marks. So that's our curriculum, and we have seen the material that you have sent already. So we want to incorporate the tests that you're conducting for the internal exams. So that's what is our plan so far. A section each, of around 80 students per class.
Right.
And the registrations are still going on. Once, I think by 10th of August it would be over, so we would be registering all of them to the course.
Okay, thank you. Yeah, if you have any more questions, I mean, even during the week time, if you have questions, please, please put it on the discussion forum so that we can answer it on the discussion forum. Or else, you can even put a chat message. We can take it forward and we can answer those satisfactory. So over and out then.